Hello and welcome to a new video. My name is Herwig Juster and today we discuss if polymer price is the most important material property. We have a look at the general material cost contributions of a molded part and discuss the volume versus weight of parts as an impact factor for polymer prices. Okay, let us get started. So let's start with the material cost contribution. So when you look on a injection molded part, for example here in the field of consumer goods, you see that the material part is with over 80% the biggest contribution factor onto the overall cost of the product, followed by machine costs, the tooling itself and the staff. So here we can say it's an example for the upper border. Whereas when we look into technical parts, this can be housing of a drilling machine, for example, the material cost factor is around 50%, so half of the overall bill of costs, followed by the machine costs, 26%, and tooling, 21%, and the staff at 5%. So we can say here in general that material costs make around 50 to 80% of our final product. This we have to keep in mind. And when we go now into volume versus weight of a part, so in terms of resin costs, the volume and not the weight of the part is important. Because when you think the shape of a part is always fixed by the design and not the weight. And therefore, the cost comparison per volume is more useful compared to the cost comparison per kilogram, for example. And here I have an example of a low density polymer versus a high density polymer. So you can see here low density is a 1000, for density of 1000, and the high density is 1500. The part volume is 0.1 in both cases. However, with the low density material, I can make with 1 ton of material 10 parts, whereas with the high density, with the same amount of material, I can only make 6.6, so in this case 6 parts. So this shows already this volume versus weight relationship. So we always measure everything into the weight, also the pricing, euro per kg, or other currency, dollar per kg, dollar per pound is also possible. But what we really have to do is to think in the volume, so say the cost per volume and not the cost per kilogram. And how to do that best now is again with graphical analysis. So we can take a certain property which is interesting for us and plot it versus the material cost in, for example, euro per liter. So really not per kilogram, but with the volume. And here I have now several examples. For example, here the tensile strength of the part at room temperature is important versus the material cost euro per liter. And when you say I need 50 megapascal in tensile strength at room temperature, I can plot now all the different materials. You can see we have from engineering, mostly engineering and commodity polymers plotted here, and you see that we can start with a high cost product. This is the yellow dot. This is PCABS. Then we have this orange dot on the same line with a polyamide 6, and we have also this blue dot, which is ABS. So in this case we have 50 megapascal and makes sense to go with the ABS because here we have the lowest cost per liter with below 2.8, and so you can always get a feeling for your part what is important and how to reflect also the costs of it. Because as we discussed on the first slide, depending if I have a consumer good or technical part, the cost situation of the material impacts much more the all over part costs. Here another example, heat deflection temperature at 1.8 megapascal. And when we say, okay, we need 60 degrees C, then I can have a look here. And you see you have several materials which have 60. So for example, we have here the dark so for example here the orange one, the PA6, and then either I can go with the here with the lowest, with the cheapest, in this case the polypropylene, or go more in this area. So it's again depending. Then also tensile modulus. So when I say okay, I need tensile strength and modulus, I can again plot, and here in this case I need minimum 1 gigapascal at room temperature. I see I have again several choices. For example, I can go with a polyketone, I can go again with a polyamide 6, or even with a polypropylene. And here the notched isot impact, again the same. When I need a high notched isot impact, like 50 kilojoule per square meter, I can again have the most economical option, the polyamide 6, and the most expensive is PC ABS. So this is a really useful tool to graphically analyze the cost situations. All these materials shown here are not filled or reinforced, so it's the pure resin. It may change when you have then filler, mineral or glass fiber. Okay, a quick summary. So it's important to balance price and performance in your material selection process. Also to be clear about the cost targets involved in the material selection. So is it cost per kilo or cost per part? And apart from material costs, we should keep in mind we have processing, tooling and assembling costs, which must be considered too. Then important differentiation between volume and weight of the part. So the shape of the part is fixed by design and not the weight. So it's better a comparison cost per volume and not cost per kilogram. And you can also work with cost factors to estimate the cost price of a product. For example, product P is equal cost factor times the material cost. For example, injection molding, when I have now this can range then cost factor from 1.2 to 2, depending if I have a consumer good or more a technical part. Okay, if you want to have more information on polymer engineering and material selection topics, I highly recommend you my blog findoutaboutplastics.com, as well as my online training courses on material selection. I will link you both, the blog and the online courses, in the description below. Okay, which video to watch next? In this video, I discussed how to turn a commodity polypropylene to an engineering polypropylene, which can replace a polyamide. So check it out. Thank you for watching and do not forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Till next time, bye.